On Tuesday, September 22nd, a 2009 flood after-action review was held at City Hall in Jamestown. The AAR was facilitated by Ken Jarolimek, and he is the training and exercise officer for the North Dakota Department of Emergency Services. Invited to the meeting were media representatives, along with agencies in the area that provided the recent interagency group discussions. And participants provided input for an after-action report, which will be sent to the North Dakota Department of Emergency Services and then to the U.S. Department of Homeland Security to receive the exercise credit in future grants. The participants identified strengths and weaknesses of this year's flood fight and recovery, along with improvement issues. Jarolimek said that the community effort was the highlight of the strengths of the local flood fight.
Well, one of the things that I've noticed in the, with the input from the group is the interagency cooperation that they all had during the flood. The different individual strengths that have been identified all go back to one thing, and that is that the agencies did proper planning, which took place for years, prior to this particular event, and then that fostered interagency cooperation or trust, among the different agencies. They all knew what their jobs were. They trusted what each other was going to do, and they just worked as a team. They had a spirit of cooperation among each other. I think that's the main thing that brought out the success of the event.
Three major areas of improvement identified were critical infrastructure and protection, with particular concerns about the sanitary and storm sewer river infiltration, interagency communications, and community preparedness and participation. Also in need of improvement, those items included a list of critical infrastructure issues, including the storm and the sewers of the sanitary nature, and the county and township road system, reevaluation of the 100-year floodplain, and the reservoir water control manuals. And it was pointed out that the community needs to be prepared in the event of a catastrophic failure of the city's infrastructure, specifically the sanitary and storm sewer systems and the drinking water supply. Identifying funding sources was another concern. Report on the input from the meeting will be drafted with future changes possible. Reporting for KCSi-TV News, this is Wayne Byers.
$24.99 per month for high-speed internet. What a deal! That's right, CSI Cable's high-speed, low-price internet for just $24.99 per month. Here's the deal. CSI Cable users can get $5 off per month for their first 5 months of CSI high-speed, low-price internet service. For the real deal in high-speed at a low price, it's CSI Cable, your hometown internet professionals. Offer details at CSICable.com.